Amelia, thank you for a meeting with me. I have very exciting news. We've been working on this for many, many years, and we finally perfected the formula for traveling back in time. So the bishops, scientists, and mathematicians have come up with this formula. The challenge we have now is that there are some of our students who got trapped back in time as it was being developed. So I would like to know whether you and your colleagues could go back and bring those students back to bishops.
Of course. Are you up for the job?
Hat, cheetah print, dancing on the people, rolled up at the after joint, dancing on the people, people dancing on the people. I got people on the people, people dancing on the people, with the people on the people, smoking CO2. See me, see you dancing on the people, climb up on the booth, hanging from the people on the people. My head hits the roof, dancing on the ceiling on the people. I got people on the people, dancing on the people. I got purple hat, cheetah print, dancing on the people, rolled up at the after joint, dancing on the people, people dancing on the people. I got people on the people, people dancing on the people, with the people on the people. People smoking CO2, see me, see you dance on the people, climb up on the booth, hanging from the people on the people, my head hits the roof, dancing on the ceiling on the people, I got people on the dancing on the people, I got people. 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 People, people. Dancing on the people, I got.
Everybody in the booth can tell myself apart from you.
the after joint, dancing on the people, people dancing on the people. I got people on the people, people dancing on the people with the people on the.
Let's excuse me, baby. No, yeah, you, baby. Back, ooh, you groovy, baby. In, let's make a movie, baby. Time, excuse me, baby. Let's, yeah, you, baby. Go, ooh, you groovy, baby. Back, let's make a movie, baby. Time.
It's Mr. Worldwide, AGA, reporting live from Cape Canaveral, MK, Big Cypher's rap.
Back in time.
Black mask, huh? Black gloves with a little bit of rope to tie. I flipped it. Black suit.
Hello, everyone. I'm Michael Goldblum. I'm the principal of Bishops, and I'm so pleased to be able to welcome you to our university. Obviously, this is going to be a unique semester, something that none of us have ever experienced. I know some of you will be living on campus in residences, some in Lenoxville in apartments, and some of you will be participating remotely. I want to begin by saying that obviously our highest priority today, and as long as the pandemic continues, will be to ensure everybody's health. And every decision we make will be first and foremost predicated on what we can do to protect everyone's health. There's lots of things for those of you on the campus that you will see, that we've got, you know, signage about which doors you can go in and go out, and hand washing stations at virtually every entrance, and we are going to be asking you to wear face coverings when you're inside any of the buildings. So a series of initiatives we put in place to try and protect everyone's health. But I want to say to you from the outset that if we are going to be successful in this, it's going to be a community effort. Each one of us is going to have to find the self-discipline to make sure that we, you know, conduct ourselves in a way that does the very best that we can to protect our own health and everyone else's in our community. So I am counting on you in this unique moment to make sure that we have a community effort to ensure that we protect everybody's health. Let me tell you just maybe a word about or two about me and then about you. So I've been the principal of Bishops for 12 years now, so I've gotten to know the place pretty well. I had other careers before I came to Bishops. I was a lawyer, and I was a newspaper publisher. I ran a YMCA, so if any of those things, lawyering, journalism, community organization, if at any point you're interested in those things, I'd be happy to speak to you about them. You'll figure out where my office is, and my door is always open, and I enjoy the opportunity to exchange with students. I can't introduce each of you individually, but I thought I would at least do it in terms of where people come from. So, a little over than half of our students, about 52% of our students, are from Quebec, and pretty much equally divided between English and French. Close to 30% are from the other nine provinces and the territories of Canada, and then about 20% from, I think this year it's 46 countries around the world. So although in Canadian terms we're a relatively small university, it is true that the world meets on our campus. And I'm going to encourage you to, not just in these first few days, although that's important, but throughout your time at Bishops, to make an effort to get to know each other. It's a very diverse community that you are joining, and you will learn a lot in your classrooms, but you will also learn a lot simply from dialogue and experience with each other. So at a time when this really is a globalized world, I think you'll have opportunities to interact with students whose first language is different than yours, who come from a different part of Canada or around the world, and there's enormous richness in that. In terms of some of the things that will be happening on campus this year, maybe I'll just mention two. Of course, there's a long list of things that will be occurring, but one of the things that we're most pleased about is that we are going to be undertaking the conversion of a building on campus that used to be called Divinity House, and it's more than 100 years old. And we will be renovating it into a indigenous center and gathering space, a place for our indigenous students that they can call their own, but also a place where all the students of the university will be welcome and encouraged to go and take the opportunity to learn a little bit more about the our indigenous students, and particularly about the Abenaki people. It's on the territory of the Abenaki that Bishop's campus is located, and we've begun a process of dialogue and discussion and learning with the Abenaki community, and we're hoping that this Indigenous Center will help further that process. The building will have a new name, and it's an Abenaki term, Kwigwamna. And it's in the Abenaki language, it means our house. The interesting thing is the Abenaki have different words for our house, one which is restrictive, more thinking, let's say, of a family unit. But Kwigwamna is a much broader perspective. It kind of means our house and your house. So it is very much our hope that this new center will be a place where all of the Bishop's community will feel welcome, and the construction project will be underway later this year. We're also renovating our student center, but once you're on campus, you'll see a number of those things. I think the campus is in very good shape, and we're looking forward to having the students back on the campus after several months of it being exceptionally quiet. In all of our minds, I'm sure, are the horrific events that we've seen over this summer, the shooting of George Floyd in Minneapolis, and then the shooting of Jacob Blake in Wisconsin, which has provoked a discussion around race and anti-racism, not just in the United States, but across Canada and around the world. And Bishop's very much wants to participate in this conversation. So we have created a task force that will be meeting for the first time next week, an equity, diversity, and inclusion task force that is going to consider, in a whole variety of areas, how Bishop's can be a more inclusive and diverse community. So that will range from the recruitment process for students and faculty, to how we integrate people, to the academic program, a whole variety of issues that we're going to be considering, and my hope is that you will all participate in this important discussion. We are proud of Bishop's and the progress we've made and the diversity of our campus, but we are still not we still do not reflect in our faculty, in our staff, in our administrators, in our students, in fully the diversity of Canada. And very much we want to make sure that Bishop's becomes that institution which is really fully reflective of the diversity of our country. A couple of things maybe just to conclude. As you may know, if you visited the campus, in addition to Bishop's University, there is a cégep on our campus called Champlain. And we share some facilities with them, and we are pleased to share our campus with them. But there's one thing I would like to ask as a personal favor to you. Because there are students from Champlain, I'm not sure when I encounter a student on the campus whether they're a Bishop student or a Champlain student. And I think the Champlain students look at me a little bit strange when I say hello to them, because they don't really know who I am. So if you do see me on campus, if you just would give me just a little bit of nod of recognition and maybe say hello, and that will make me comfortable in greeting you. And it's one of the things that that we pride ourselves at Bishop's is that we are a people place and that we do take the time to speak to one another and get to know each other. And maybe just to finish, to say that, you know, COVID, of course, is affecting all of our lives. But we are determined that it's not going to define us, it's not going to define our institution. And one of the special things about Bishop's is each generation of students, each class of students, defines the university. So you are now Bishop's University, and you will determine what Bishop's will be over these next 3, 4, 5 years. And I hope that you will contribute to it continuing to be a place that values the human interaction, where people do respect each other, that people take the time to get to know each other and to converse. I encourage you, not just in these first few days, but over your time here, to take the time to get to know each other. Everyone has a different story and a different narrative. And for those of you who won't be able to join us on campus this semester, it's very much my hope that you will have the opportunity to do so soon, because we very much believe that education is more than just the transmission of information. Education emerges from the intellectual dialogue and exchange that happens between professors and students, and between students and each other. So we're very excited to be starting the semester. It will be a unique journey for all of us. I look forward to meeting you individually once you're on campus. And I hope that whether you're participating remotely or in person or in a hybrid model, that Bishop's will meet your expectations, and that we will be able to help each one of you achieve your aspirations, accomplish your dreams, and that we will equip you for when you do come to graduate to be constructive citizens of our country and of the world, and to be a people who are going to have rich, interesting, and satisfying lives. So, as I say, very much looking forward to seeing you. Welcome to Bishop's, and let's have a great year together. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Enzo, I'm the SRC president this year. I just want to welcome you all to Bishop's, whether you're in person or online. I hope that I get a chance to see all of you and to meet all of you. If you see me, please stop me to say hi. I love to chat to people, and I'd love to get to know your name. I know this week is a very interesting week, and for a lot of you it's a huge milestone, so embrace it. Just be sure to stay safe, do what you feel comfortable doing, make sure that you're protecting yourself, others, and be you.
Hi everyone, I'm Izzy. I'm this year's VP Student Life. Somehow this year, despite everything, we have more for Student Life than we ever have before. I'm really excited to see you all here in person, safely of course, and I hope you have a really wonderful year. If you need to approach us for anything, please feel comfortable doing so, and can't wait.
Hey everybody, my name is Cedric Moore. I'm this year's VP of External Affairs. What that means, I deal with everything off campus, from advocating on your behalf to outside organizations and other universities, as well as organizing fun events to do off campus. Fun fact about me, I love fun facts and alpine skiing. I'm really excited to see you all this year for Frosh, and I hope to have many beers with many of you.
What's up, you guys? I'm Hannah. I'm your Director of Communications and Marketing this year. I'm basically the face behind all of the SRC Instagram accounts and the O-Week accounts. So if you see me with a phone this week, make sure you do a big smile. And I hope you guys have a great week. We'll see you around.
What's up, everybody? I'm Bernard. People call me Bernie, and I'm your Director of Finance this year. So welcome to Bishop's. Welcome to the best 4 years of your life. Can't wait to meet all of you. Cheers.
Hi everyone, I'm Amelia. I'm your Director of Events for this year. I've been working all summer long to put together the best O-Week possible, and I'm super excited with what we've come up with. We have so many events in store for you, and I know you guys are going to have a wonderful time. Your leaders and judges have been working hard the last couple of days to make sure that everything is on theme, all the costumes are ready, so it's just your guys' job to make sure this is awesome. As Director of Events, I'm in charge of doing Country Fest, Survive the Gate, Winterfest, and Grad Formal, and I hope that we can have each and every one of those events this year, and it's all on you guys. So let's have a great week, and let's have some fun, and see you around.
Hi, I'm Josh Vidit. I'm your VP Academic. I handle all things academic during a week. Enjoy your week and stay safe.
Here are just a couple of rules that we have on campus. We have 3 bars for you, so you can't drink anywhere in any open space on campus. Rooms, bars only. If you want to smoke on campus, we have a couple of designated smoking areas set up in a couple of places. You can find them on the maps. No weed anywhere on campus because we got a daycare here. We got to protect the kids. O week is a drug-free week, so no drugs. Don't do them. Drugs aren't cool. In order for us to be able to do all these events, you guys have to wear your mask. So if you're at any single O week event in your O week shirts, wear your mask and then we'll be great.
Hi, welcome to Bishop's University. My name's Carson Brooks, manager of security here at Bishop's University. My main objective here at Bishop's is to make sure that all the campus and all of its users stay safe. I'm directly responsible for overseeing a department of 15 employees who work 24/7, 365 days a year. We're one of the only departments that runs every day, and there's a variety of different ways that you can reach us. The easiest way to reach us is to download the SafeGator app on your phone, where you can have a variety of different important messages sent directly to your phone, as well as report different events or contact security if there's an emergency. You'll also notice around campus a bunch of emergency phones that will directly call security once they're picked up. They're red phones, they're located in all of the academic buildings and spaced out around campus. I work directly for the Dean of Student Affairs, who oversees all of the non-academic student conduct, you could say, and we give out some automatic fines. Our goal is not to fine students all the time, but we are mandated by the university to enforce the rules and regulations. We give out automatic fines for a variety of different things. Could be open alcohol, non-cooperation, smoking in non-designated areas. And we also issue summons, which means that if should ever you have a run-in with security and there is any questions, we'll issue you a summons and invite you to have a meeting with me later on in the week or with the Dean of Student Affairs. You will notice this year that the start of the school year is very different from any other. I've been here for 19 years and it is by far one of the most unique starts to the school year. But please understand the university has done everything they possibly can to keep the campus as safe as possible. We will remind everyone over the course of the coming weeks, to wear their masks, social distance, follow the directional signs. There's the SafeGator squad that will be walking around campus. You'll see them in the coming days. They're already on campus working. They're there to provide information and direction should you need it. The security officers will also be going around. You'll see us on a variety of different times during the day and night, enforcing the rules and regulations and reminding students to, social distance or follow rules in general. Like I said, I won't take up a lot of your time. My main goal here is to make sure that you guys stay safe and you have fun doing so. We'll be around all week. The security office is located in the Dewhurst Dining Hall building, which is directly where the on-campus cafeteria is. And we're open 24/7. If there's no one in the office, there's a red emergency phone directly here where you can contact us. There's 15 members in my department that are ready and available to answer any questions you might have. We are the first line of questions or answers for most campus users here on campus. We respond to all of our officers are first aid certified, so we respond to all medical calls, general inquiries, fire alarms, intruder alarms, and any needs there might be on campus. Our response time is fairly quick because we're here on campus and we have a variety of different first aid equipment at our disposal to help out during different emergencies. Like I said, the easiest way to reach us is to download the SafeGator app on your iPhone or Android to be able to contact with us. I hope you guys have the best start of the school year you can, even in these trying times. Thank you and welcome to BU.
Hi, my name is Miriam Pierre.
I'm Anna.
I'm Steph.
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Quinn.
And we're your head judges.
We've been working all summer along with Amelia to create a really fun O week and really nice events for you guys.
We're also overseeing all leaders and judges,
as well as overseeing and running all events.
And we're here for you guys for any questions, comments, and concerns.
And we'll be on campus all week giving out fun challenges.
Get ready! See you soon!
Hi, everyone. My name is Gab, and I'm a safety judge this week for O week.
I'm Mackenzie Russell, and I'm your safety judge for O week.
And I'm Nathan, and I'm one of your other safety judges.
So our goal this week is to keep everyone safe, all while having fun. And don't worry, we're not here to police you guys. We're here to enjoy our O week as much. much as we can. If ever you need anything, like water or snacks, we've got you covered on that.
If you need to talk, we've got you covered.
If you need a band-aid, somewhere to sit, or just anything else like that, we've got you covered.
Don't be afraid to reach out to us if there's anything you need. We're here for that.
Mahalo, my dudes. My name is Bishop Carrascrew, and I'm one of this year's Green Judges. Myself, along with my fellow judges, Salma and Jackson, will ensure that you are actively participating in lowering your impact throughout the whole week. We will be doing this by giving you eco-friendly challenges, as well as educating you on some initiatives that take place in Lenoxville. So get ready, get stoked, because your O week is going to be totally tubular. Peace and love, my dudes.
Hey, Gators!
I'm Sophia.
And I'm Natalia.
And we're the
CSI Judges.
CSI stands for Cultural and Societal Inclusion.
So one of our main focuses for this O week is to make international students feel welcome in this community. We know how hard it is to come from a different country, to experience a little bit of a cultural shock, but we want to make that cultural shock good, to make international students feel like Bishops is a very, very inclusive and welcoming community. And that is why we're running very, very fun challenges this week.
So just remember, no matter where you come from, we all bleed purple!
Hi, I'm Emma Story.
I'm Eric Gendron.
And I am Maria Clavelli.
And we are
your academic judges.
So on Tuesday, you guys are going to be joining us for academic tours. You'll get a good chance to see our beautiful campus, and you're going to get a chance to see where your classes are going to be, and it's going to be a great day. I can't wait to see you guys there.
And we'll also be giving out a lot of fun challenges all orientation week long, some academic, some otherwise, so we're excited to give those to you.
We're also here to be a good resource for you guys if you have any questions regarding classes or academics. So if you have any of those, just come up to us and we'll try to answer them. So yeah, and remember,
school is cool!
Oh my gosh, that's embarrassing. I didn't see you there.
Hey, I'm Erica.
And I'm Emily.
And this is Fanny. And we're this year's charity judges.
We love Bishops, and so our job as charity judges is to give back to the community. This year, our chosen charity is Debuku La Dignite.
This is a nonprofit organization run out of Montreal that works to empower visible minorities through providing economic and educational resources. This allows them to succeed both professionally and personally.
Erica, how are we going to raise money?
This Thursday, we're going to throw a super awesome, fun sticker and plant sale right here in the quad.
This wouldn't be possible without the help of some amazingly talented and creative Bishop students. We can't wait to see you there.
Say bye, Fanny.
Chers amis, je suis Wilner Caillot, président du collectif De vous pour la dignité. Il me fait plaisir de vous présenter le mouvement en quelques minutes. Donc, merci de votre grande attention. De vous pour la dignité croit que dénoncer quoi qu'essentiel n'est pas suffisant. Face à ces iniquités qui affligent les communautés racisées, l'étape de l'organisation efficace, respectueuse et agissante des forces vives et diversifiées s'impose. Si plusieurs mouvements s'activent, nous disons qu'ensemble, ce ne serait pas une addition des impacts, mais une multiplication des réussites. D'autres communautés ont eu le courage, la discipline de s'organiser et prendre leur place. Elles ont su créer de meilleures opportunités pour les leurs. Nous ne sommes pas condamnés à l'échec. Non, nous racisés, nous ne sommes pas voués à l'humiliation en perpétuel. Si cette génération le veut, nous pouvons nous tenir debout et fiers, faisant reculer l'injustice sociale à l'endroit des racisés et des plus vulnérables. Donc nous pouvons construire une synergie économique en voyant des entreprises de plus en plus fleurissantes et manant de nos communautés avec des emplois de qualité pour les nôtres et les autres, favorisant le respect de soi et les avancées académiques. Nous pourrions devenir des incontournables pour les partis politiques qui cesseront de nous donner des miettes ou de nous tenir pour acquis en nous banalisant. Nous pourrions mettre à profit la force du vecteur féminin en valorisant nos femmes doublement et triplement discriminées. Nous accompagnerons nos aînés en créant ce qu'il faut pour qu'ils vivent leurs dernières années dans la plus grande des dignités. Nous serons présents pour nos enfants et nos jeunes qui doivent prendre leur place dans cette société. Nous nous levons debout, nous sommes capables, soyons fiers de nous, travaillons, organisons-nous. La force est dans le nombre quand le nombre s'est s'organiser. Donc, debout pour la dignité, croit qu'un avenir meilleur est possible. C'est ensemble que nous allons construire cela. Donc, nous travaillons et agissons sur cinq grands axes. Il y a la justice sociale, il y a la synergie économique, il y a l'éducation, le vecteur femme et ce qu'on appelle aussi la pression politique. Donc nous sommes sur ces terrains-là. Sur le terrain de la justice sociale, Debout pour la dignité a divers objectifs. Donc défendre l'égalité en dénonçant l'injustice perpétrée à l'endroit des racisés et des personnes vulnérables, profilage racial, discrimination au niveau du logement, employabilité, rapport avec la DPJ. Donc assister et accompagner à des victimes d'injustice dépourvues de moyens de la défense de leurs droits. Donc nous accompagnons nos migrants et les nouveaux arrivants sur le terrain de la synergie économique, donc créer une banque d'informations sur les emplois, débouchés, postes disponibles dans tous les domaines, donc informer les racisés de ces débouchés-là. Création de réseaux de professionnels fiables, c'est-à-dire croiser l'offre avec la demande. Faire connaître les racisés qui ont quelque chose de bon à offrir et aussi faire connaître les débouchés pour ces entreprises de racisés. Favoriser le réseautage d'entreprises sans se cannibaliser. Favoriser l'entrepreneuriat, orientation, accompagnement, mentorat, aide à l'investissement, information, prêt, bourse, etc. Donc la force de pression politique, donc mobiliser les racisés en un groupe de pression politique, favoriser le vote stratégique et en bloc, favoriser le financement politique légal, éthique et stratégique, développer dans l'unité un rapport de force pour mieux négocier nos dossiers, enjeux et intérêt. Donc, sous le vecteur femme, favoriser l'émergence du leadership des femmes racisées, créer et supporter des programmes répondant aux défis des femmes racisées doublement et triplement discriminées. La force de l'éducation, éduquer et enseigner les racisés et les vulnérables quant à leurs droits et à la défense pacifique de ceux-ci. Sensibiliser les non-racisés à cette réalité quotidienne d'injustice, ignorée consciemment et inconsciemment. Contribuer via la divulgation de l'information et des réflexions. Donc, contribuer via tout cela à la construction d'une société plus juste où la diversité est célébrée, respectée, implémentée dans toutes les sphères de la vie sociétale. Favoriser la poursuite des études supérieures des racisés et des vulnérables. Dénicher des stages en entreprise pour nos finissants. Donc, debout pour la dignité, nous travaillons sur ces cinq champs, justice sociale, synergie économique, force de pression politique, force du vecteur femme, force de l'éducation. On attend que vous, que vous soyez racisés ou non racisés, ensemble, nous pouvons donner naissance ou faire en sorte à que nous ayons une société plus juste, plus égalitaire. Ne l'oublions jamais. La force est dans le nombre quand le nombre sait s'organiser. C'est une question de fierté, debout pour la dignité. Merci.
There are basically three kinds of points you can get towards your team: bronze, silver, and gold. They're pretty self-explanatory, and the challenge that you do reflects the amount of points you'll get. At any time, if you don't want to do a challenge, that's no problem. And if you do want to do a challenge, make sure you bow down to anyone in an orange shirt.
your leaders will give you a link to a virtual safe box. This is a place to put any comments, concerns, complaints, compliments you may have throughout the week. It's completely anonymous. Use it whenever you want. This is for you to be heard.
And I also wanted to mention that we're going to be having a safe space on campus for anyone to go to if they just need a zen place to go hang out or just want to meet some different faces. So if you ever want to go hang out with them, they're by the Student Union building and you'll definitely come to know where they are.
Hi everyone, we're going to show you how Dewey's works now with the new COVID restrictions. Come along.
Hello, good morning. I am Molly and I'm your cashier. Welcome to Dewey's. We have sanitizer hands, please. Okay, so I'm bringing you in for your lunch. You have to swipe your card there. Or just pretend you did it in the country room. There we go. Okay. Great. I have to give you your utensils.
Okay.
And you need to follow the arrows on your way in. Stay to your right.
Okay. Thank you. My name is Trudy. I'm the head supervisor here. I'll answer any questions or whatever you have. Just give you a quick tour of what we have available to you. This is the men's bathroom here. It's really important to just follow me.
So you see we're going to keep our distance.
This is the ladies' washroom right here. And you can also see this year that this is going to be one of our new policies. There's no bags, no jackets to be hung up here. So your school bags and your bag stays in your dorm, and your coats will go on the back of your chair. So it's very important that nothing is hung up here due to sanitation. Okay, follow me please. So as you're entering the dining hall, you have to know exactly what you'd like to have. So if you'd like to have stir fry, you're gonna follow this line right here. If you'd like to have the grill, you're gonna come over here. So we're gonna go to the grill first. Okay, this is our grill. Over here, you will make your order, and you'll pick up in the same place. And we have cheeseburgers, hamburgers, poutine, so on and so forth. Yeah. So then if you decide that you have changed your mind and don't wish to have the grill, excuse me, we're gonna go over here, follow the arrow, and we're gonna go to our stir fry. This is an express lane right here. You would have already decided when you came in if you were having stir fry. Okay, so the small dots are for the ones who are on stir fry station. I'm in the express. Over here is our hot table. We have hot meals. We have breakfast here from 7:30 to 11. 11:30 to 2:30 is dinner. And 4 to 7:30 is supper. And that's available to you here. And over here this year, this will be the deli. And what will be available to you here will be the sandwich of the day. And there'll be different little small pastries and such, I believe, as well. It's going to be here. So if you get this far, and you decide that you'd like to have coffee, follow me over here. So at this station here, this is our dessert station, which you can get coffee, dessert, chocolate croissants.
Your toast or whatever in the morning, whatever type of breakfast will be found here. And then you take and follow the arrows.
Back around.
Arrows are very important. And we're going to go into the dining hall here. This is our allergen station over here. If you have any questions, it's ask the people behind the screen or ask the cashier. This is the end for me. I'll pass you
up to John. Okay. All right, so as you can see, we have changed the dining room around a little bit. There's the same amount of tables, just less chairs. So we've spaced the tables out and put one chair per table to ensure proper social distancing. We ask that once you cross the line and come into the dining room, you go find your seat. And once you reach your seat, then you can take off your mask, begin eating. Once you're done eating, yes, put your mask back on. And instead of crossing back in like you used to, we ask that you go this way, whether it's to drop off your dishes, which will be here against the wall, or here against the wall, or whether you want to go for a second serving, Last year you used to be able to duck right back in. This year we ask that you come down this way, following our arrows. And you head back down towards the cashier and start the circle all back over.
Okay, there's different sections set up over here for your forks and knives, your plates, your teaspoons, and so on and so forth. Follow the system, please.
Are there any time restrictions for how long you can be here?
No, there's no time restriction, but we do prefer that you come in, you enjoy your meal. We do want you to enjoy the meal here at Dewey's. We don't want you to have to rush, but in the same time, respect that we there is other people on campus with a limited amount of places. We think like half an hour is a good time, but we don't put that on limits to anybody, no.
Okay. Cool. Well, that's all for me. Thank you so much.
So from all of us, to all of you new, your new students, welcome.
Welcome.
The ones
welcome.
That are coming back, welcome back. Welcome to the new norm.
That's right. Welcome to the new norm.
So, welcome Gators. Bienvenue. Bienvenidos. I'm Miles Turnbull. I'm the Vice Principal Academic and Research, and I'm also a professor in education. A really warm welcome to Bishop's University in the fall of 2020. You are very special. Every group of new students is very special, but let's call you the specialist cohort of new Gators. Maybe some of you are thinking, oh my God, what's this COVID semester and this COVID year going to look like? But remember, you'll be able to tell your grandchildren or your friends throughout the years as you reminisce and come back to Bishop's at your 10th year reunion, your 20th year reunion. Remember that fall of 2020 when we started at Bishop's in the middle of a world pandemic, a global pandemic. How many students can say that they started the university studies during a global pandemic? I know you're going to love this institution. I came here 6 years ago and I love it. It's quite a special community, very closely knit. You've chosen to participate in our orientation week this year. Get to know your friends, either in person, virtually, or a combination of both, just like your classes will be for many of you. Now, Principal Goldblum probably said to you during his opening speech that he encouraged you to say, "Hello, Mr. Goldblum," walking down the path. So every year, I always challenge you, the new incoming Gators, to say hello, Dr. Turnbull, or hello, Vice Principal Miles, as you walk down the path, or as you send me an email. And in fact, we have a little friendly competition to see who gets the most hellos, or the now, this year, in our virtual world, the most emails, or the most likes, or the most winks, or whatever. So listen, enjoy your orientation week. It will be very special, memorable. Do yourself an honor. Stay safe. Be good. And get to know friends, be it in person, or virtually, or both, that will remain friends for the rest of your life. Bienvenue, bonne chance, and do us proud. Enjoy all week.
Good.
That work?
Yeah.
The sound okay?
What's up, what's up, what's up, everyone from Bishop's University? Welcome to Bishop's University on the mighty Massawippi Shore. Oh, yeah. I wish I could be with you in person, but I'm not. So guess what we're going to do? We're going to make it count. We're going to make it count like never before, and we're going to come together like never before because we are Bishop's University, the home of the Gators. Woohoo! Welcome to Bishop's University. My name is Cameron Hughes. I'm from the class of 1996. Woohoo! That makes me a few years older than you, a bit more experienced than you. Not much, but it makes me having experienced many of the same things that you've experienced today in the last few days and are about to experience. So welcome to Bishop's University, a beautiful campus, a beautiful community. You are now part of the Bishop's University family. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I just want to share a little bit of a story with you. I went to Bishop's for, like many of you, small school. I could get involved. Great little town, beautiful campus. People from across Canada and the world. It just made sense to me. I'm from Ottawa, so it wasn't too far. I went to Bishop's. My first year, I wasn't sure what I wanted to study. I was pretty involved in the student council and the government, and I loved spirit. My second year, I'm living off campus. My roommate in one of those homes along College Street, he played for the football team. He said, "Cam, I need you to do something at the games. We need to bring the energy up." I was like, what could he possibly mean? So as the week rolled around, the big game on the Saturday, I painted my face purple. I made a D and a fence. I got a purple cape and this crazy outfit, but I was missing something. I was missing something, my friends at Bishop's. So I went to the local grocery store and I bought a massive watermelon. The guy's like, "What do you need it for?" I'm like, "Don't worry." I went back to my place. I carved it out. I put it on my huge head and I walked all across campus with my signs, my cape, and I walked into the football game in front of 3,500 people from the community and fellow students, and Melonhead had arrived. My friend Mark is on the sidelines looking at me like, "Cam, is that you?" I'm like, "Damn straight, it's me." And we raised the roof. We brought school spirit from here to here to here. We all came to the games, from football games to basketball games to soccer games. We supported everyone on every team, doing amazing things, not just athletics, but everywhere. And school spirit was rocking. One of the main reasons, one of the huge reasons we come to Bishop's University, to be part of that special spirit. When you put on the purple, you are a part of something incredibly special that so many fellow alumni have been a part of. So for 25 games, I wore a watermelon on my head. I know what you're thinking. You must have been single for your entire university career. Maybe. So I had some academic issues. Let's just leave it at that for now. So I took some time off to go back to figure out what I needed to do with my life. And I'm in Ottawa at this time, about 4 or 5 months after Bishop's. Not after Bishop's, but in between Bishop's. And I go to a hockey game one night, an NHL Ottawa Senators hockey game with a buddy of mine. It's the first period, it's quiet. It's the second period, it's quiet. It's the third period. And my buddy says, "What's going on?" He looks at me and I go, "I've got to do something." He's like, "What do you mean?" He goes, "It's too quiet. We come to these games, we got to have fun. Let's get this party started." So out of nowhere, with 8 minutes to go in front of 10,000 people, I stand up on my chair and I start to dance like an absolute maniac. And everyone in the crowd's like, "Quick, get some medical attention. He needs help." And then they realized I was just trying to have fun. I was just trying to get people going. I was just trying to get excited. That's what it was all about. Next thing I know, I sit back down and there's a roar in front of 10,000 people go crazy. I sit back down in my seat. My buddy's like long gone. Just kidding. And I sit there and I realize now, 26 years later, the reason I've had this accidental career, this lucky career, this fortunate career, performing at sporting events around the world, in 12 different countries, for 30 million people, in 40 states, 9 different provinces, 22 different sports leagues, and I've only been hospitalized 8 times. It's not because I got up the first time. It's what I did next. Then whistle blows, play stops, boom, I jump up out of my seat the second time, I run to the aisle, and I start dancing up and down the aisle, going absolutely nuts. And guess what the fans did? They rose out of their seats and they cheered with me and they were going absolutely crazy. Because I stopped looking here, here, and I looked here for permission. It all came from here. Next thing I know, the Senators asked me to come back. And then I showed up for other teams in Toronto, across the US, across Canada. And I've been living this crazy, crazy, exciting, fun, yes, difficult at times, career, trying to prove myself. But it all starts from here, my friends. So welcome to Bishop's University. This is where it comes from. And this, my friends, it comes from here and the community supports you. When you take chances, when you put yourself out there, when you join teams, when you join intramurals, when you join clubs, when you challenge the school to be better, which we all need to do, we need to rise to the occasion right now more than ever. We are Bishop's University on the mighty Massawippi Shore. So wherever you're from across Canada, the United States, or the world, welcome. Welcome to Bishop's University. Myself, an alumni, and so many, all of us across the world are so grateful you chose Bishop's University. Welcome to the family. Have an amazing Frosh Week. Have an amazing orientation. Get to know everyone. Try everything. Bishop's is about the experience, and you're about to be blown away. Let's go, Gators. Let's raise a toast to Bishop's University and the mighty Massawippi Shore. Cheers. Woohoo! Let's go, Gators!
Shades on, mask on, let's have a good time.